I think I took the Avery experiment as probably right. In the same sense that you could say, well, there was a lot of reasons why it wasn't right. In the same sense, you know, I've taken black eye, who you killed, lower. Yeah, it's probably a fact, okay? That's not 100% proven, but sometimes you have to act, you have to make a choice, even though it's not 100% truth, all right? So, if you looked at it, Avery's experiment was probably right.
But the phage group did not have this view.
No, don't ask me. Maybe because, you know, Max never took what is life seriously. I did. Probably because he knew Schrodinger and or had met him, and Schrodinger wasn't mystical the way he was in my eyes.
So how did you get to Copenhagen?
Because Herman Kalkar was in the United States. I don't know why. And he was at a phage group meeting in St. Louis in the fall of 1950. And I talked to him. And he had got a hold of a little radioactive adenine or something. And he wanted to, was talking about what Kornberg did, you know, trying to find a cell-free system to make DNA. Yeah, so I went to Copenhagen sort of thinking this is what Kalkar would put me to doing. But discovered that when I got there, his lab was working on nucleoside synthesis, how you link the sugar versus the base. It just realized, you know, I could do that for 2 years, but I would be no closer to what the gene was. And so soon after getting there already, I think we would. I think I hadn't met him before. The Danish microbiologist Ole Mulle had visited Caltech and wanted to switch to working with bacterial viruses. And he'd been doing some form of curing bacterial infections. But then wanted to do it, and so he welcomed Gunther Stent and I, who both saw Herman's lab as a total loser. And particularly when, within weeks after her arrival, which was simultaneous with mine, of the postdoc, Barbara Wright, Herman announced to everyone that Barbara was his heart's desire, and he had left his wife. And I would have described the camping trip at great length and avoid boring people. That was a woman I just wanted to be as far away from as possible. So, you know, Herman's lab just lost. But I think even Barbara hadn't been there. Nucleosides was just too boring. And at the Copenhagen Harbor phage meeting, Seymour Cohen had, there was, say, 50% of the DNA of the parental phage got into the progeny. And somehow, then there was a question, well, could there be two sorts of DNA, genetic DNA and non-genetic DNA, and only the genetic DNA would pass? And Seymour Cohen said, well, if you do two generations, if there's genetic DNA in the second generation, you get 100% transfer. So actually, from the moment I heard that, I wanted to do that experiment. And so I did it in Copenhagen in Mulle's lab and got 50% the second generation, and we knew as little as we did at the start. And so it was after the failure of that result that I went off to Naples and with Kalkar and Barbara. And in the middle of May, there was the small meeting on macromolecules where Morris Wilkins showed up instead of Randall and showed the crystalline A photo. And, you know, the moment I saw that, I, you know, it was like seeing, you know, the perfect girl. Anything you, any other girl was uninteresting once you saw that. So, so a whole series of just lucky events. But, well, you know, with the general rule that if you sit at home, it's a bad idea. And so when you're young, you should just travel around as much, meet as many people, and go to a lot of meetings. You don't know what you're gonna, who you're going to meet. You know, you can sort of stay at home at 80, but it doesn't pay when you're 20.